Jacqueline Schultz here with Talent Recap on the virtual red carpet of America's Got Talent. Last night was another incredible show. We are going to be talking to all the contestants and also Mr. Terry Crews himself. I'm going to go with Alex first, even though I'm super scared to interview you. Yeah. You scare me.
Please don't.
Just don't say anything mean. I'm not prepared, okay?
I'm not. It's too early for that. Come on.
All right, good. I want to know what made you decide to try out again for AGT.
You know, that first performance was so legendary, and I really think people thought that I would disappear forever. I think most people would have. You know, my fiance called that performance any normal person's worst nightmare. And all it did was show me that I'm unbreakable and that I'm fearless and that I can handle any situation. So I wanted to come back on the show to basically say, I'm still here, I'm not afraid, and I've only gotten better since the last time you saw me.
So you're not a one-hit wonder. No one can get rid of Alex. I wanted to know, like, if perhaps, I'm keeping my fingers crossed, I love you, that you're going through it. If perhaps you didn't go through, are you coming back to audition again? Are you just going to keep auditioning?
I don't know. You know, I think what I've done with the judges has, I think I've hit a wall with it. I think people have seen it and they know to expect it. And if there's anything I don't want people to do, it's to think that they know what's coming from me. I always want to be different and surprised, and I always want to grow. So if I did it again, I would do something completely different than what I've done before.
I saw that you practice on objects. Is there anyone that allows you to practice on them? Like, do you have any friends or family that's like, go for it?
Some of my comedian friends will allow me to just like rip them apart. But mostly my two pugs, they just sit there and have to take it, you know? And they actually look, my boy pug looks a lot like Simon Cowell. So it was very easy to practice. They have the same set of wrinkles and a little turned up nose. So I would just look at him, and his name's Carlton, but I would call him Simon, and I would just do these jokes again and again. So it made it a lot easier.
So my dad compared you to Don Rickles. My dad is Howie, by the way.
Yeah.
My dad compared you to Don Rickles. I want to know if you have any comedy heroes.
Yeah, of course. I mean, of course, Don Rickles is the most legendary roasting comedian of all time. I mean, he defined that era along with Johnny Carson and Dean Martin and all these people that were just unapologetic toward their friends and their heroes. So people like that and Dave Chappelle, and I mean, modern day, like Ron Funches, Kyle Kinane, Rory Scovel, Ricky Gervais. I have so many people that I look up to that inspire me to just truly be myself and do the kind of comedy that I want to do.
I love that. I mean, next time, you should probably say Howie Mandel. Too.
I know, I was just about to say, and also, Howie! Hey, I used to watch Bobby's World religiously growing up, so.
Me too.
I'm a little young for saying elsewhere, but, you know.
Well, I love you. I think you're amazing. I love roast comedy. So good luck to you. I'm keeping my fingers crossed.
I appreciate that. Thank you so much, Jacqueline.
Thank you. Okay. Resound.
Yeah.
Thank you. So how are you feeling after last night's performance?
I think honestly, you know, there's always the nerves, of course, but we feel really great about what we left on that stage. And so, you know, regardless of what happens, I think there's kind of this confidence that, you know, we did what we planned to do. And so I think we feel pretty good about it.
Now, we heard in your opening package that you're not able to perform live shows right now. Have you found other ways to perform virtually during this pandemic? Like, how have you pivoted?
Yes, we have found ways to perform virtually. A lot of churches, clubs, kind of conferences, all kinds of things. They're starting to have events via Zoom, or they have this elaborate production where we recorded and they put it all together with the whole lineup of other artists. So we have been doing things like that. We have been singing birthday songs to our supporters and fans. We all individually are doing things to try to bring in more money and invest it in our individual dreams and in our collective dreams.
I love that. And how I think the topic or the theme of last night that my dad kept bringing up was raising the bar. So how do you plan to raise the bar next time?
So next time, I think that we're going to do something that, you know, America wouldn't expect. And, you know, we're still going to give you those big moments, but I think that we're going to try something different and something that's a classic possibly. And so, you know, you never know what you're going to get from us. You know, you just got to keep on watching. But yeah, I think that we definitely are aiming to raise the bar, and I definitely think we will.
Joseph, are we going to see your niece?
not in this round, but you will see me and my niece in the future, yes.
Okay, because I think we've seen a lot of her. That video went viral, right? It's our niece everywhere. You guys are viral superstars. All right, so how do you guys, you're so positive, and you're such like a ray of light. What?
Somebody's at our door.
They're giving us breakfast.
Give us 1 second.
Sorry. Oh, okay. I you go eat.
The knocking in the video.
No, you finally just come during this time.
I'm knocking hard.
This is the beauty of Zoom. I usually do the interviews on the red carpet, but I like this so much more. There's eating. There's people popping in. I love it. But you guys stay so positive. You're such like a ray of sunshine. How do you guys stay so positive all the time?
That's all of us, because I'm very positive all the time too. I don't know.
I think that, you know, we just have seen different adversities and kind of come up against different things, and we just are in a really great place to be able to spread that love, joy, and hope. And we never want to lose that. You know, we never want to lose the light that we have. And so we want to share that with as many people as possible.
Well, we love you. Thank you so much for sharing that with us and with AGT, with the world, everyone watching, and good luck to you.
Thank you.
Hey, what are you doing tonight? Well, I think you should hit that subscribe button down below, and then we can talk.